然后这个用使用这个天象这个字呢，希伯来的原文呢，这个字那个 tava 这个字呢，是就是用来指那个天使的这个字。
So this, it says this little horn cast down some of the host and some of the stars to the ground and trampled them.
所以这里面就讲到说，这个小角呢，居然可以升高到那样子的高的地位，然后呢，它可以把一些的这个angelic being 就是天使们呢，能够抛到地上来，抛落在地。
Remember that the stars is a common reference to angels.
大家记得吗？就是说星星呢，星呢，常圣经常常用星来代表天使，好像那个耶稣手中所握的那个七，就七个天使，七个使者。
Jesus had the seven stars in his right hand, which are the seven church, seven angels of the seven churches.
哦，好像启示录里也手握着七星，然后那个七星呢，就是七个教会的天使或使者。
So this little horn grows up among them, and he can cast some of them to the ground.
所以呢，这个小角，它可以一直升到那么高的地位，然后把其中的一些呢，就把他们践踏到地上，抛落到地上来。
So the implication is if the ten horns are demonic, then the little horn ascends to their level.
所以呢，在这里面所看到的图像呢，就是说这十个是魔君，他们就是恶魔，是高权位的恶魔。但是呢，这第十一个角，这个小角，它是慢慢升到他们那个地位来。
He goes from here up to here.
他从一个这个地位跑到这个这样子很高的权位的地位来。
He has now a like nature to those ten kings.
所以呢，他就升到跟这十个魔君这样高权位的魔君呢，有类似的一个同等的一个地位跟那个能力或者性情来。
In other words,
本质来。
In other words, he's transformed from simply human to a genetic hybrid between Satan and human. He literally becomes the beast.
所以呢，就是在这个过程当中呢，他渐渐的呢，就转换成从一个完全的人呢，他就转换成为了那个天使跟就是转换成为那个恶魔跟那个或是撒旦的基因跟人的一个基因的混种的结合，他就不再是人，而是成为那兽。
Now we have recombinant DNA, and we'll let this play so she can explain it better.
A common technique in genetic engineering is to insert a new gene into a loop of bacterial DNA called a plasmid. The molecular tool used to cut DNA is a restriction enzyme such as EcoR1. The enzyme has a precise shape that allows it to run along the groove of the double helix, scanning in the case of EcoR1 for the base letter sequence GAATTC. The enzyme then cuts the plasmid at this specific point, allowing a new piece of DNA to be inserted. When it cuts, EcoR1 leaves a sticky end. This helps the new gene to attach.The joins are then stitched together by another enzyme called DNA ligase. The genetically engineered bacteria is grown in a culture medium. Very quickly, large numbers of the bacteria can be produced, each with a copy of the inserted gene. The bacteria duly manufacture whatever protein the gene codes for, and so the desired product is made.
So what we learned from that is that it is now possible to take a piece of DNA, you can open it up, put in a foreign strand of DNA, you're literally copying and pasting into this DNA to make a hybrid DNA strand.
所以现在的生物基因科技呢，已经告诉我们说呢，我们可以把这个基因链呢，把它给中间给它切开，然后呢，然后去拿另外一个不同的基因呢，把它给它放到里面，然后呢，就重新就再把它接回来，然后它会开始产生复制，就好像有点像我们电脑里面的那个 copy and paste 这个样子。
I was shocked when a high school biology teacher told me that they are doing this in the advanced placement high school biology classes.
然后呢，我很惊讶，因为有一个生物老师，他告诉我就在那个高中的比较那个高级的课程里面，他们现在就在做这个。
Now what I see this why I see this as being significant is because it is possible to change your DNA.
我看到为什么说我要特别讲这个东西呢？因为我从这里面看到一个可以改变你我的 DNA 的可能性。
I don't know if we can currently do this on living species.
我不晓得我们现在到底是不是现在就能够在拜在现在生存的这个物种里面来做。
We can ask at the Q&A time.
Q&A 的时候，对。
But I believe it's just a matter of time before this becomes a reality.
但是我相信呢，在不久的将来呢，这就会成为一个现实里面的东西。
So what I see happening is the Antichrist will receive the information, the seed from Satan. He will then code that and then inject it into himself.
所以呢，我相信呢，这个敌基督呢，有可能呢，他是。能够接受到那个撒旦他的那个 DNA 基因里面的 DNA 的那个码那个资讯，然后那个东西呢，他能够把它植在他的自己的 DNA 里面。
So this will be a counterfeit of the incarnation.
这个呢，就成就了所谓的伪造的道成肉身。
I don't believe that he's going to be born as the Antichrist.
我不相信说他呢出生的时候就是等于是撒旦跟人的女子结合产生的。
I believe God gives everyone an opportunity to choose.
我相信神呢给每一个人有选择的机会。
And so now you have someone who's made his choice to serve Satan and wants the ultimate upgrade.
然后呢，可能这个人呢，他就是选择了他要侍奉撒旦，他不要侍奉神，而且他要达到一个最高的权力的巅峰。
And Satan is going to make that available to the person he chooses.
然后撒旦呢就会使用这个人呢，将这个的这刚刚所讲的这种基因重组的科技的东西呢，就加在他身上。
Oh, okay, sorry. Let me go back here. Sorry. Now it's interesting because scientists successfully have embedded silicon chips inside human cells.
所以呢，现在科学家已经成功把细晶片植入人体的细胞里面。
Now, biological cells can also contain tiny silicon chips. Experiments found that living human cells can ingest or receive injections of silicon chips and continue functioning as usual for the most part.
现在生物的细胞里面已经能够含有跟细晶片可以相容。实验发现，活的人类细胞可以吸收或者接受植入的细晶片，而且大部分的细胞都还能够持续正常的功能。
More than 90% of chip containing HeLa cells still survived a week after receiving their silicon loads.
所以呢，超过90%具有晶片的海拉细胞都能够在注入那个硒以后呢，能够继续存活一周。
So I don't know how Satan is actually going to deliver his information to the person of his choosing.
我现在还想不透撒旦他用什么样的方式呢，要把他的这个基因的密码呢，基因的码呢，把放到这个敌基督里面。
But what I see is that we are well on our way to a solution for that problem.
但是呢，我们就看到说，这个可能性呢，它是的确是有一个解决的可行的途径来达到的。
You might say, well, how could Satan even give his code to somebody?
那你可能觉得，那撒旦怎么可能去把他自己的码去给了别人呢？
Well, this has to do with synthetic biology.
那这个呢，就要讲到所谓的合成生物学来。
Craig Venter and his team have built the genome of a bacterium from scratch and incorporated it into a cell to make what they call the world's first synthetic life form.
那这一位呢科学家呢名字就叫克莱格·凡特，他的团队是第一个成功创造所谓的融合生物学的这个团队。他们从无到有制造了细菌的染色体，然后把它放到细胞里面，成为全球第一个所谓的融合生命体。
And I want to share with you a short video. It's called Synthetic Biology and the DNA Printer. And it's just fascinating because you see what is currently possible where they can take DNA, they can put it into the computer, and then they can literally print it using what they call a DNA printer. Let's watch.
那这里面等一下就要看这个所谓的核。
After 10,000 years of genetic manipulation via selective breeding,Humans finally gained direct access to the genetic code. Deoxyribonucleic acid, DNA. Since then, we've cut and pasted it, photocopied fragments of it en masse, sped read it with sequences, printed out the code letter by letter in the lab, modeled it on computers,and measured it with microscopes. For 40 years now, we've called this work genetic engineering. The trouble is that while there's been an extraordinary amount of genetic discovery and manipulation, There's been precious little engineering. Engineers are frustrated by genetics and molecular biology. The experiments are too slow, the complexity too messy, and growing more so all the time, and there's a frustrating lack of standardized components. They'd like to do to genetic engineering what engineers have done since the Stone Age: collect, refine, and repackage nature so that it's easier to make new and reliable things. Engineers want to treat DNA more like a programming language. Instead of ones and zeros, A's, T's, G's and C's. They want to use DNA to write simple, Lego-like functional components, inspired by, but not found in nature, and then run them in a cell instead of a computer. The only difference is this software builds its own hardware. They call this re-engineered genetic engineering synthetic biology. Nowadays, rather than cut and paste the DNA sequence out of one organism and into another, you can, if you know what you're doing, just type your DNA sequence into a computer, or copy it from a database, or even select from a growing component catalogue. And then you just order it over the internet. Yes, really. The DNA sequence may be copied from nature, but the DNA itself is made by a machine. It's synthetic. The raw material for synthesizing DNA is sugar, $25 of which will buy you enough to make a copy of every human genome on the planet. The chemical letters are fed into the DNA equivalent of an industrial inkjet printer. In goes your sequence information, and out comes DNA, at a cost of less than 40 cents per base pair and getting cheaper all the time. It's then freeze-dried and shipped to your door.
So这讲到未来的他们在想象的所谓的基因重组的科技，可以简单到好像由DNA的基因的列印表，然后你选择你要什么，你就上网订购，我要这个那个那个，然后到最后呢，他会就是邮寄到你家，你就可以把那个东西收过来，以后呢，你可以可能可以自己住进去。
All right, so let's put all these pieces together now. We've spent a long time taking a look at how all this could be possible. We started with Revelation chapter 12 and 13, or 13 and 14.
我们从那个启示录12章13章14章那边开始，一整天，包括昨天这样研读到现在。
And we know that in the last days, the Antichrist is going to require everyone to take the mark of the beast.
我们知道呢，到了末世的时候呢，基督要
And Scripture is clear that if you take the mark of the beast, you are doomed forever.
但是呢，另外一方圣经就又严厉的警告说，你如果接受的印记，你将永远沦。
We're told that without this mark, you cannot buy or sell.
所以呢，圣经告诉我，没有接受这个受的印记的，你不能做买卖。
People have thought that it might have been a barcode.
所以呢，有的人就认为说，哦，这是用来做买卖用的。
Maybe a computer chip.
所以他们才想说是一个晶片啊，或者是一个条码。
But what I began to see from Genesis 3:15 is that it's a complete transformation of the person.
然后呢，但是我是从创世纪三章十五节的那个角度来看呢，这个其实受的印记呢，就是要把整个人类的那个基因重新有一个改造，或是改写。
So we've also seen now that there are a lot of smart people with big money that are working on genetic alterations or transhumanism.
所以呢，在这个《时代》杂志呢，大概半年前左右，他就在这个封面就说，Google可以解决死亡的问题吗？是吧？所以呢，在现在全世界呢，有许多的聪明人，又有钱的人，正在进行基因的改造实验，所谓的超人类主义解决死亡的问题。
Right. So again, as Paul mentioned, we have can Google solve death, and then we have the 2045 initiative where they're trying to make the singularity occur by 2045.
所以呢，另外呢，就是在这里呢，你会看到这个他们又定了一个目标， 2045年这个 Avatar 就是我们看到那部电影叫什么？
And I believe that when Satan
阿凡达那个电影里面，实际上现在有一个 Avatar Project， 他们有设立的那个年度目标，到2045年的时候，他们要这些目标一步一步的达成。
Yeah, they believe that by 2045, we will have everything necessary and in place for mankind to make the ultimate